down. Well, pick me up with golden hand. Hombre, say, hombre, tell you to run. Hombre, say, hombre, on. Oh,
Good evening. It's going to stop. It's going to hold off. It's not going to rain. Been told. Anyway, welcome tonight. Parents, family members, school board members, administration, and teachers. On behalf of 469 members of the class of 2012, I've been asked by them to welcome you and to thank you for joining us on this very special evening. This ceremony marks the culmination of years of hard work, goal setting, sacrifice, personal growth, highs and lows, and all states in between for the students and for their parents and guardians. Tonight we celebrate the end of a long journey, but an essential journey. Once we conclude this ceremony, these graduates will begin a new phase of life as proud Dallastown Area High School alumni. And we are confident that this new phase of their life will be a successful one. At this time, I ask everybody to remain standing as I call on our junior ROTC cadets for presentation of colors. Please remain standing as Richard Howey, our co-class president, comes out to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
seated.
Close your eyes, it's there.
We would like to recognize this year's retirees. If you are in attendance at tonight's ceremony, please stand at your seat. Susan Angelilli, Wendy Arnold, Juanita Bridell, Lynn Cheeseman, Michelle Dietz, Jolene Delone, Melissa Earhart, Linda Eichelberger, Linda Fry, Mary Lou Garner, Patricia Hartman, Linda Kashner, Ronald Kaufman, Brenda Keller, Patricia Krantz, Jeannie Linemans, Marlene Marchant, Susan Mason, Jill McCracken, Christine Miller, Jerry Myers, Susan Ness, Douglas Noble, Annette Petroli, Nancy Pinkerton, Richard Robach, Vincent Reaver, Jennifer Strickler, Joanne Waltmeyer, Douglas Whitehill, William Zimmerman. Thank you so much for all your hard work, dedication, and loyalty to the Dallastown Area School District and our students. In addition, we have two exchange students graduating with us tonight whom we would also like to recognize. Would Clara Jarova from Czech Republic and Maria Jose Adedo Nunez from Chile please stand? We wish you the best as you travel back to your friends and family at home. Thank you.
Members of the Board of Directors, Dr. Fouth, members of the faculty, honored guests, parents, and members of the graduating class of 2012. Yesterday, I talked with the graduating class, so tonight I will keep my remarks brief. Brief because you are eager. Eager to get the diplomas for which you have worked so hard. You are eager to join your family and friends to share your joy with them. You are eager to get started with your plans for the future. And this is as it should be. For a graduation, far from being an end, is the beginning of all your tomorrows. Over the past several years, you have worked and studied, practiced and played, and grown. Grown mentally, physically, and emotionally. And now you're here, ready to begin your lives as members of the adult community and to be a contributing member of this vibrant democracy. For some of you, this will mean a job and the responsibilities of family living. For others, it will mean post-secondary studies, college, technical studies, and further years of study. Whatever course your future takes, it is my sincere hope that you will look back on your years at Dallastown as having prepared you to meet and overcome the challenges that life will present. We'd like to hear from you about that preparation. What did we do, and how well did we do it for you? Your input will help us to fine-tune our program, so please, let us know. To each and every one of you, please accept our wishes for a happy and productive life, the respect of your fellow human beings, and the love of your family. May the future be yours. The best of luck and congratulations to the class of 2012. And now a special part of our ceremony that's a tradition, a longtime tradition here at Dallastown. On behalf of the Board of School Directors of Dallastown Area School District, it is a privilege to present the 2012 honorary diploma to a person who has contributed greatly to the growth and development of commerce and education in Pennsylvania and Maryland, Mr. Robert A. Kinsley. Mr. Kinsley is Chairman and CEO of Kinsley Construction Incorporated, a heavy and general construction company doing business primarily in South Central Pennsylvania and Northern Maryland. Kinsley Construction was founded in 1963 and currently employs a staff in excess of 1,600 field employees and 150 management personnel who are engaged in design coordination, estimating, and project management. Engineering News Record rates Kinsley Construction 129 out of the top 400 contractors in the nation. Quite an honor. Mr. Kinsley is well known in Pennsylvania and Maryland as a preservationist, having restored many historic buildings in York, Pennsylvania, as well as the Gettysburg Hotel in Gettysburg. He is a founding member of the Farm and National Lands Trust of York County and is a board member of Better York. An ardent supporter of community improvement, Mr. Kinsley was founding member in establishing the Agricultural and Industrial Museum in York. He was the chairman of the Board of Trustees of York College of Pennsylvania, and he was founder and is currently chairman of the Gettysburg National Battlefield Museum Foundation. Mr. Kinsley has served on numerous community organizations, the York Foundation, the executive board of the York Adams Area Boy Scout Council, the Board of Directors for Junior Achievement, the South George Street Community Partnership, and the Community Advisory Board for the YWCA of York County. When he's not pursuing business activities, Mr. Kinsley enjoys his horses, farming, fox chasing, fly fishing, and American history, particularly the Civil War era. Mr. Kinsley and his wife, Anne, reside in York. He and Anne are the parents of five sons who are all associated with family-owned businesses. They also have 11 grandchildren. And now we recognize Mr. Robert A. Kinsley for his many contributions to our community with his honorary diploma. Mr. Kinsley. Congratulations.
Dr. Dreyer, thank you for that introduction. Are you sure you have the right person? With all that, maybe I didn't have much time to work. Fellow graduates, this is a great day, an evening of celebration that recognizes a moment in time where we have, as graduates, successfully completed the first chapter of our formal education. It is only the beginning. The jumping off point to the world of vast experiences. Now the real education will begin. It is now a point in time where we can decide which avenue of pursuit we wish to take on the path through life. I urge us to plan, map out our journey, and realize our dreams. It is an honor for me to stand here today before the class of 2012. I am a product of Dallastown Schools. This high school complex had not yet been constructed when I graduated from the eighth grade. Many of my fellow classmates went off to graduate from the high school in Dallastown, or we continued our high school years at William Penn, known as York High. So for me, it is an honor to receive this honorary diploma. Carly Henry is one of my classmates. Congratulations, Carly. I do have fond memories of my school years at York Township Elementary School and then to the four-room building down on School Street, where we, as seventh and eighth graders, continued our education moving from teacher to teacher. We only had four teachers. They taught us our lessons. We thought we were pretty hot stuff. Oh yes, and during my tenure at York Township, spankings were still used as an acceptable method of persuasion, and I remember a few of them. Mr. Marsteller, the principal, was called to administer some punishment. As I was at a time an unruly student, those events I well remember. They did improve my respect for the teachers and the expectations set for me. I clearly also remember that I was the last to be chosen to play on the baseball team, and I noticed that I was not mentioned in either the popularity or honors group of graduating eighth graders. So with that being said, I was amazed when my assistant, Nada Lau, got a call asking if I would be present this evening. After all, I was not what you would consider a diligent student or star athlete. I thought long and hard about accepting this invitation. What in the world would I say that could make an impression that you all here tonight might remember? Shortly after accepting the invitation, a funny thing happened. My wife and I, Ann, were planning a vacation to some of our national parks. In the course of that evening, I thought it might be a good idea to go to the library, my library, and consult an atlas so I would know the location of some of these possible destinations. As I removed the atlas from the shelf, you can never guess what fell out. This booklet, Yearbook, York Township Schools, 1954. That's the truth. I immediately forgot my research mission and began reading the yearbook for the eighth grade class. It spoke about the dedication of the York Township Elementary School, to which 2,000 people attended, school trips to Warner's Dairyland in Red Lion, and other places of interest. One of those trips was to the Gettysburg Battlefield, and that left quite an impression on me. Little did I know that someday our family would be partnering with the National Park Service to build a new museum and visitor center in honor of all those who fought there for the freedoms that we all enjoy this evening. That booklet also stated that we suffered through year-end exams and that we waited for the results of those exams with uneasiness. What has changed in those ensuing 56 years? Evidently, I passed. In reading the yearbook, I was most impressed by the teacher's farewell message. In summary, it stated, and I repeat, for years, your parents and your teachers have been guiding and directing you. You have been given all the advantage within their power to excel. After all, nothing worthwhile is achieved without teamwork and support from so many. I think that the class of 2012, as the class of 1954, owes our parents, grandparents, and teachers a round of applause in appreciation for what they have done for all of us. The farewell message further relates that in the years to come, we hope that you will be the recipients of many more intelligent benefits. And we hope as you receive these benefits, you will share them with others. I personally urge you to share and give back to society as you journey through the next chapters of your lives. The satisfaction of giving back will be the most rewarding moments you will ever experience. Of course, I further looked and read all the names of my fellow classmates. It brought back fond memories. As time passes, you will have those fond memories. Build lasting friendships upon them. As I concluded my reading of the yearbook, I began to remember my path to this point. I think in junior and senior high school, I knew I wanted to build things. Although I didn't have a job when I graduated from high school, like now, 1958 was also experiencing a recession. I did a few odd jobs. Then lo and behold, I got a job offer to operate a backhoe from C. Joseph Deller right here in Dallastown. Now my real education began on the job training, or better known as the School of Hard Knocks. I did attempt to further my education by attending York Junior College. I must confess that I would have rather been outside working with my hands, So after a year at college, I returned to operating the backhoe, digging footers and installing drain fields. By the end of the summer, I realized that I returned for my sophomore year, I would need to earn more money. I consulted Mr. Deller, asking him if I could grade and seed the lawns around the homes where he was performing the excavation in my spare time. Little did I know that this experience would lay the foundation for our family construction business as it lays today. For those of you who have a summer job or are off to college, I applaud you. If you don't, volunteer for some worthy cause. It will bring you a level of satisfaction and enhance your resume and may present you with the opportunity you are seeking. Thomas Edison once said, "Opportunity is missed by most people because it is dressed in overalls and looks like work." I would like to leave you with one last thought. Robert Kinsley. Success in life is like a sporting event. If you keep your eye on the ball and play by the rules, practice respect, and have a high degree of ethics, the scoreboard will take care of itself, and you and those around you will become the winners. Thank you for listening and inviting me to attend this evening. Thank you.
Outstanding.
Truly an outstanding speech. Next, we would like to introduce, and it is a privilege to do so, the president of our school board of directors, Mr. Butch Potter.
Thank you, Dr. Dyer. I believe it was 20-some years ago, George Bush gave a famous speech about 1,000 points of light, about those people in America that really make a difference. And I think we just met one right here this evening, Mr. Bob Kinsley. Thank you, Mr. Kinsley. On behalf of the board, I'd like to add our congratulations to all the graduating seniors, faculty and staff, family and friends of the class of 2012. This class grew up with the Harry Potter series of books and movies, classic tales of good and evil. I also have a connection to Harry Potter, but I'm just glad my parents didn't name me Harry. This is your evening of celebration, and all of us are proud to share this moment with you. In a few minutes, you'll become a Dallastown graduate, ready for your next step. After 12 years of homework, tests, lectures, labs, sports, music, and other activities, you're finally here, ready for graduation. But the learning doesn't stop here. It's just getting started. Lifelong learning is not just a fashionable cliche, but an achievable goal. In any walk of life, opportunities to learn and improve are out there if you seek them. The current recession has been long, and the job market is not that great right now. But like the weather, the only thing we know for sure about the future is that it will change. According to a recent Gallup poll, 58% of all Americans believe that this generation will not have a better life than their parents' generation. I ask you to prove them wrong. As long as we have our freedoms, we'll have that opportunity, and you will succeed. You're better educated than previous generations. You have more tools, more technology, fewer barriers, and more opportunities in more places than ever before. There are many fields of work and study that didn't exist 30 years ago. Many things have changed since that time. Computerization is everywhere, and the tech revolution is really just getting started. In 1970, Alan Toffler's best-selling book, Future Shock, predicted that the accelerating pace of change would drive all of us crazy. We're not there yet, but the overwhelming power of instant communications, we might get there sooner than we think. Managing this technology efficiently will no doubt be a career for many of you. As you go forward, take charge of your future. As Chevy Chase said, see your future, make your future, be your future. And whatever you do, follow your dream, use your talents and all of your energies. The opportunities are out there. A wise man once said, find a career that you love and you'll never have to work another day in your life. That is my wish for all of you. Good luck and congratulations. Thank you.
Well, guys, I'll start this off the old-fashioned way. Well done. It was a long, hard-fought battle, but we're finished now. I've always been excited to graduate, to move on to the next chapter, but at the same time, I didn't want to leave. I didn't want to leave behind all the friends I've made and all the memories I have. I don't know how the rest of you feel, but this school has treated me right. But now the day is finally here. I'm ready to move on. Yes, I'm still gonna miss this place, but I couldn't be any more confident in the brilliance of our future. You parents have raised an incredible generation. I know this day is supposed to be about us, but we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for our parents. My parents are the reason that I have succeeded thus far. They gave me my intellect, and they guided me to the right path. Some of us will grow up to be scholars, some of us artists and musicians, and some of us leaders. And some of us have arguably the most important quality. They're very attractive, especially Chris Curry. Yeah, Toph. And it is now our duty to take our God-given gifts and use them to succeed. I've strived for success my whole life, and I guess that's why I'm standing in front of you today right now. But I don't think it's fair to measure success in terms of GPA. That's not how success will be measured in our future. So then, how should we measure success? Is it measured by who you know, how well you are connected? Do you know a senator? Have you ever met the president? Do you have over 17,000 friends on Facebook? Is it measured by the amount of retweets you have? On and on it goes. Because we live in a celebrity culture, it matters to all of us who we know. Knowing important people gives you authority. It helps you get things done, and it elevates you in the minds of others. But these things, these letters of recommendation, the approval and recognition of others and the applause of the world, these are not true measures of success. Some of us will measure our success in terms of our income. I originally thought that money equaled success, but it seems that the lover of money never has enough. The lover of wealth will never be satisfied with gain. For me, I plan on measuring my success in the amount of lives I've changed, and this will be hard to measure, but that's a good thing. I'll always have something to work towards. I don't know how successful I've been this far, but I know that you guys have. This school, the staff and the students, they've changed my life. I will be forever smarter, stronger, and happier because of my experience here. I need to thank two people especially. One, Kevin Engman. He made me laugh for about 10 years straight and always brightened my mood. And also John Hikes, great role model, and I wouldn't be up here if it wasn't for him. Now our senior quote is, happiness can be found in the darkest of times, when only one remembers to turn on the light. But I don't know how to apply that to this moment or our future, because I don't see darkness ahead. I only see excellence. Thank you.
Jones, and I would like to start off by congratulating all the graduates sitting in front of me today. I know we thought this day would never come, but here it is. Your one last chance to shake hands with your favorite teacher, take a picture in your cap and gown, and say goodbye to our beloved alma mater. This is the time where we close one chapter of our lives and open another into a bright future. These memories here at Dallastown might fade, but the lessons we learned here will last a lifetime. Throughout the journey of life, we will find there to be many ups and downs. On our way to getting where we want to be in life, there is sure to be darkness. but there is also a guarantee to be happiness right around the corner if you are willing to take the chance to find it. Most of us can say we have already encountered struggles here at Dallastown, whether it was a challenging math class, running the mile in gym, or simply making it to class within those brief 6 minutes. However, we have all found a way around these obstacles and came out pleased when we were able to find the bright side of the situation. But at this moment, the end has arrived, and we are leaving our sense of security behind to embark on a new and unpredictable stage of our lives. It is now more than ever that we must remember the knowledge we gained here, not just the information measured on a grade point average or displayed on a transcript, but the education we received from one another. The perseverance and drive that was instilled in us at Dallastown will carry throughout our lives and allow us to find the best in any dark situation. This ability to overcome any circumstance will transcend high school and what we have accomplished up to this point. We will all be receiving diplomas tonight, but think about what you have really taken away from your 4 years in high school and the knowledge you have truly earned. I ask you to reflect upon the lessons that have revealed themselves to you and finally opened at the close. Thank you.
Good evening, graduating class of 2012. As your class meteorologist, I think the weather turned out perfectly. And to be honest, when I found out about making this speech, I was really preparing something humorous, perhaps sharing a story or two about my job at Sheets or trying to convince you that life is like made to order. But it turned out to be a little bit different, just a little bit more serious than where I wanted to take it. Our class quote this year, around which all our speeches have been tailored to fit, if you haven't noticed just yet, comes from Albus Dumbledore. And it is, happiness can be found, even in the darkest of times, if one only remembers to turn on the light. It's a pretty confounding quote for a children's series, to say the least. The world in which we live is both a dark and ominous place, filled with poverty, illness, theft, war, and famine. As young adults, we'll all be challenged by these problems in some aspect. But whatever those may be, my advice to you is to seek out the light in your lives. Go to your close peers, your family, and your virtues, what you spend 13 years at Dallastown and other school districts to develop. I can't guarantee that after you've done this, the darkness will go away, but I can guarantee you that you'll be much better off knowing that you stayed an honest individual to yourself and to your community. That, my friends, is your biggest legacy. Whether or not you lead a success story in life doesn't matter. By being sincere, you let your own light shine, and it in turn leads to a happy, healthy lifetime. I certainly wouldn't be up here today had it not been for this advice given to me by my mom, my dad, grandparents, brother, aunts, uncles, and friends. So, in the coming years, look to those around you, but then look at yourself. If you see that honest individual, then you found the light. And when you found that light, you'll never walk a day in your life concerned about your happiness or well-being. Have a wonderful time with your friends and family this summer, and wherever you end up this fall, I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you.
No worries, guys. I'm going to keep this short because I know we're all itching to get our diplomas. What is happiness? Well, for those of you who know the iconic Peanuts gang, according to Charlie Brown, Lucy, and Linus, happiness is two kinds of ice cream, knowing a secret, climbing a tree. Happiness is having a sister, sharing a sandwich, getting along. Happiness is anyone and anything at all that's loved by you. Well, joy can be found in the smallest things in their lives, a concept that may seem unrealistic for us. I mean, how often are you truly excited by finding a pencil or eating a piece of pizza with sausage? Perhaps we need to take a different approach to finding this thing called happiness. Former British Prime Minister Benjamin Disraeli once said that action may not always bring happiness, but there is no happiness without some sort of action. What this man is getting at is that we must either find or create our own happiness. Things that bring us joy in life are never going to simply fall out of the sky into our laps. We must go out and actively search for them. I know you've all heard the phrase carpe diem, seize the day, and all the rest, but there's a truth within the cliche. People are not cats. We don't have 9 lives, we just have 1. We must make do with the small amount of time we are given on this earth and use it to accomplish great things, to make a difference, to find true happiness. A wise man once said that 85% of life is just showing up. Happiness is equally existential. It can be found in everything you do, everyone you're with, and everywhere you go. However, if you sit around, happiness will surely pass you by. It is only there for those who go out and really live, for those who take the time to do something they love, and for those who experience everything life has to offer. We only have 1 chance to get the most we can out of life. You only live once, Dallastown. Make sure it counts.
Your class quote, happiness can be found in the darkest of times when only one remembers to turn on the light, likens you to J.K. Rowling, the young, iconic character Harry Potter in her 3rd installment of the Harry Potter series, The Prisoner of Azkaban. Like the character, you've reached an exhilarating time in your life that promises new and exciting experiences. Coupled with the prospect of these new experiences is a natural tendency towards nervousness, and that accompanies the uncertainty of the unknown. But much like the character, you will overcome. You need to do nothing more than look at the friendships, the memories, the learning experience that you have accumulated here while you've been at Dallastown High School to know that you are capable of accomplishing anything. We heard that in the service the other day. I challenge this class not to only turn on the light, but to be that light. Joshua Chamberlain, a famous Civil War general, and the governor of Maine believed that every one of us had a spark within us. You have labored, you've excelled on the classrooms, on the playing fields, on our stages of this school for many years, and today you're ready to begin that journey. During your 4 years, you've shown that spark to your parents, to your teachers, to your friends, in all of your endeavors. I challenge you to be that light and to be that beacon within this community. Use your talents, use your skills you've exhibited, and make a difference in this community and in this world. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my time to be able to brag up the class of 2012. During their 4-year tenure here at Dallastown, we have an impressive list to tell you about. At this time, I'd like the honor graduates in the top 10% of this class to please stand to the applause they deserve. I guarantee you that's not only the best in Dallastown, it's the best in the state of Pennsylvania, it's the best in the United States, and the best in the world. Also, the National Honor Society, the National Order Society, and the Volunteer Awards have all been courted tonight. If you've been courted, please stand for the recognition you deserve. Thank you. This group always hears me talk about giving back. They have volunteered collectively over 10,700 hours back to their school and their community through volunteer hours. Our seniors helped lead a fundraiser drive, the volunteer club, that sent over 90 boxes to our military personnel around the world, and they also helped raise funds for the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation to a total of $14,460 this year alone. 35 of these seniors in this class served as link leaders in our new freshman transition program. Members of the seniors in this had winning athletic teams, including division championships in baseball, golf, boys and girls swimming, girls tennis, league championships in boys lacrosse, and girls and boys soccer, and a district runner-up in softball, playing even today. And sportsmanship award we're proud of, are recipients in the girls cross country, the boys lacrosse, girls tennis, boys track, and wrestling. One senior was an indoor state champion in pole vaulting, and another senior made the ESPN High School All-State lacrosse team. Many of our seniors held key positions in the cast of the musical Hairspray, which brought honor to our performing arts program by winning at the Best of Performance at the Rosies. Dallastown seniors also won Rosies for the Best Female and Best Male Performer of the Year. Nine of these seniors were selected to district chorus, district regional band, and district orchestra. Many seniors participated in performances at Heinz Chapel in Pittsburgh, Disney World, Universal Studios, and Carnegie Hall, and with the Dallas Brass at various community fundraisers. Many of these seniors performed at over 60 marching band events and 20 concerts. Seniors were among 19 award winners at the bronze and silver levels on their national Spanish exam. A member of this class earned national recognition in Scholastic Arts and Writing Awards, and another was honored by our exemplary volunteer service by President Barack Obama with the President's Volunteer Award. Members of this class distinguished herself as the 2012 Distinguished Young Woman representing the state of Pennsylvania. One member of this class is recognized as number one in the United States for his marksmanship skills. One of our seniors has led the engineering applications team that won a national award at this year's Toshiba NSTA Explorer Vision competition. And another senior outscored 92% of all second-year physics participants internationally in the 2012 Physics Bowl contest. 10 members of this graduating class hold Girl Scout Silver and Bronze Awards, and 8 members of this class have achieved the status of Eagle Scout, something else to be very proud of. 4 members of this class are in the community and on the fire services that come out to help us during emergencies. 1 member is spending another year volunteering with AmeriCorps, and another will be spending a year in France courtesy of a Rotary scholarship. To sum it all up, 88% of this class is going on to post-secondary education, 4% of them have enlisted in the military, and 7.5% are entering apprenticeships in the workforce. When they put in all those applications to all those post-secondary institutions, scholarship money has been offered to the members of the class of 2012 totaling $4,714,000. At this time, it's my honor to the Dallastown community to call the class of 2012 to the stage to receive their diplomas.
Brianne Taylor Bell.
Catherine Elizabeth Arvin.
Andrew David Booth.
John Ross Allison.
Sierra Jesse Beeler.
Megan Danielle Anderson.
Timothy P. Boring.
Anthony A. Barnhart.
Lauren Lee Beck.
Mukhtar Barba.
Cassidy Gray Billett.
Emily A. Ashenfelder.
Jeffrey Charles Bracken.
Elizabeth Marie Anderson.
Ryan Lee Bowman.
Michael Lloyd Beachy.
Caroline Marie Bixler.
Corey Gray Bakel.
Elizabeth Sarah Bear.
Jared Matthew Allison.
Derek Robert Breitner.
Cote Adeo.
Justin Marshall Bogert.
Michael Nonso Abenawe.
Laura Ann Ball.
Emily Mead Ackerman.
Molly Catherine Blakely.
Adil Abdallah.
Alec Kenneth Bogart.
Mariah Lynn Abrahamson.
Dalton James Brenner.
Ryan Richard Bender.
Kirsten Rand Baker.
Madison Riley Bakel.
Alexis Marie Bowers.
Cody Charles Bensel.
Matthew Eugene Browning.
Ashlyn Elizabeth Bailey.
Jesse Scott Davis.
Michael Emery Baylor. Beekler, sorry.
Alicia Balan Claiborne.
Rachel N. Brenneman.
Dana Michelle Clayton.
Rachel Bragg.
Wade M. Cook.
Zeth Andrew Bonowitz.
Hannah Elizabeth Church.
Nicole Marie Brent.
Charles Frederick Cooper Jr.
Devin Barker Callahan.
Rhea Cherie Cole.
Jillian Charisse Brabham.
Patrick James Conroy.
Justin Allen Carr.
Randy M. Krismer.
Austin Bennett Kellerman.
Ryan Patrick Creedon.
Devin Ray Cheney.
Angelica Rose Connors.
Jennifer Nicole Boyle.
Blaine Patrick Cregan.
Lauren Elizabeth Brown.
Cassidy Irene Cook.
David A. Butler Jr.
Zachary Adam Clayton.
James Raymond Ziegler.
Joanna Chen.
Danielle Leanne Byers.
Brandon Allen Culp-Hennies.
Madison Young Bowser.
Jency Claudio.
Gregory Scott Burry.
Kimberly Virginia Copeland.
Jason A. Chavez.
Mia Lachelle Chapman.
Teresa Marie Casolo.
Alex Chatterham.
Ashley Nicole Darrington.
Megan Julia Dowden.
Shane Thomas Campbell.
Andrew Scott Bradford.
Megan Nicole Curry.
Devin Bernard Fink.
John Philip Dettinger.
Abrielle Tulia Donato.
Cameron James Durr.
Jacqueline Ariana Doolin.
Khalees Shabri Davis.
John Robert Feathers.
Jake Stewart Dunnigan.
Tyler Fisher.
Kayleen Marie Curry.
Alexandra Catherine Dalla.
Tori Ray Davis.
Morgan Elizabeth Digert.
Todd Sterling Dawson.
Michael John Farrell Jr.
Nathan Robert Eichholz.
Allison Marie DeLegge.
Kiara Lee Cruz.
Joseph Ryan Fix.
Christopher Mark Curry.
Danielle Aaron Eschenauer. Excuse me, Eisenhower.
Caitlin M. Deerdorf.
Christopher Michael Ferris.
Dion Gerard Eldridge.
Juline Nicole Deppin.
Abigail Marie Crone.
Jacob Scott Fleckenstein.
Joshua S. Cunnings.
Nico Tyree Evans.
Amber Marie DeFabio.
Brittany Dellinger.
Haley Ruth Couch.
Seth Ian Douglas.
Kevin Lloyd Engman.
Erica Renee Fondervest.
Blake Allen Barshinger.
Alex Paul Faircloth.
Laura Morgan Green.
Caitlin Nicole Garbrick.
Giovanni Emilio Frenda.
Justin Michael Gray.
Lauren Nicole Fischel.
Tessa Marie Galante.
Catherine Caslow Feehan.
Timothy Brian Gray.
Benjamin Stephen Fry.
Nicole Elizabeth Geldmacher.
Taylor Nicole Fisher.
Ian Mitchell Godfrey.
Benjamin Joseph Fraticelli.
Michael David Godbolt.
Olivia L. Fagan.
James Trent Green.
Timothy Aaron Fry.
Aaron Nicole Fry.
Nicholas Kyle Forwood.
Christina Gelati.
Caitlin May Fitz.
Austin Theodore Grothy.
Megan Eileen Faby.
Richard James Gibney.
Adam V. Ganty.
Lauren Gillespie.
Kirsten Irene Fleischer.
Rachel May Forey.
Brandon Patrick Flynn.
Derek Jansen Grove.
Andrew Walker Geezy.
Molly Marie Gingrich.
Mackenzie Catherine Ellinger.
Andrew Taylor Hurd.
Isaiah William Houck.
Ellen Louise Hendricks.
Courtney Marie Florey.
Michelle Elizabeth Hartman.
Kevin Malcolm Hare.
Zachary Alexander Hudson.
Mackenzie Ann Groff.
Caroline Nicole Henry.
Casey Ellen Green.
John Michael Hudish.
Dane Connor Hartman.
Aaron William Inkroth.
Tyler A. Helsel.
Clarissa Tirsa Hargan.
Morgan Taylor Gross.
Elena Martine Herbst.
Drew Lee Anthony Hess.
Thomas E. Hubitz Jr.
Emily Rachel Gorski.
Michelle Paige Harbert.
Jessica Marie Grismala.
Bennett James Jensen.
Christian Andrew Hansen.
Heather Nicole Harbaugh.
Jackson P. Hoffman.
Rachel Claire Hess.
Courtney Marie Golden.
Benjamin Luke Johnston.
Brittany Ann Guess.
Jordan Ryan Houck.
Brooks William Hannah.
Michael Nicole Hoffer.
Carly Ann Godstree.
Danielle Alyssa Hom.
Thomas Hannigan Hallway.
Dylan Ray Ketterman.
Sean Hanlon.
Caitlin Joy Keller.
Stephanie Garcia.
Tyler R. Hewitt.
Carly Joe Hamburger.
April Nina Kensicki.
Darian Hobson.
Cody W. Lauer.
Richard Francis Howley.
Get out of here.
Amanda Nicole Kaufman.
Stephanie Danielle Inners.
Damon Andrew Lawrence.
Tyler B. Wise.
Jonathan William Lemangan.
Andrew Bryce Castor.
Aubrey Marie Kepperling.
Intense Asuko Inyang.
Brandon Lee.
Christian Nelson Kashak.
Morgan Brooke Kashner.
Adam Michael Katura.
Creelin Elizabeth Kynard.
Lindsay Sumi Ha.
Kyle Zachary Konkowski.
Justin Lee Michael Calandris.
Bria Joe Kadish.
Shauna Rose James.
Benjamin Matthew Lehman.
Alexander Colin Kepperling.
Caitlin Bella Nice.
Jade Nicole Wise.
Ethan Gregory Klein.
Taylor Brooke Jennert.
Ellen Bailey Jones.
Colin Parker Jones.
Nicholas Ryan Lehman.
Dennis Hanhei Kim.
Lauren Holly Krebs.
Clara Girova.
Michael Aaron Clayhold.
Nicole Jean Hollis.
Aubrey Stedman Malone.
Jamin Glenn Kynard.
Cody Michael Kilburn.
Damani Eshe Johnson.
Ian James Markey.
Judd Allen Gemmel.
Love you.
Maria Delray Lytle.
Kelsey Lee Langston.
Patrick Ryan Marianos.
Ty Christopher Lair.
Karen Elaine Mann.
Brooke Renee Langston.
Daniel Philip Mashuda.
Matthew Lewis Jr.
Emmett James Marianos.
Stephanie T. Lee.
Jessica Catherine Martin.
Joshua Ray LaValle.
Caitlin Jane Lux.
David James Linton.
Lauren Marissa Litvak.
Cassandra Marie Landis.
Anthony John Matero.
Erica Michelle Lee.
John Michael Margovich.
Austin David Lurch.
Cheyenne C. Litvak.
Alexander Christian Long.
Colin McLean.
Kelsey Elizabeth Laird.
Rebecca Joanne Maurer.
Paul Allen Leapart.
Sean Francis Mann.
Nicole Blair Lighthizer.
Bethany Nicole Lilly.
Taylor Morgan Lang.
Dylan Andrew Rowland.
Austin Lee Littrell.
Sabrina Rosalina Rogers.
Aaron Samuel Leib.
Christopher James Robertson.
Laura Elaine Lesher.
Josie Musso.
Lisa Yejin Kwan.
Cody Michael Norris.
Adam Joseph Lutz.
Corey Jack Norris.
Logan Clark Miller.
Ashley Marie Ness.
Abigail Faith Melcher.
Cody M. Knoll.
Felice Marie Mendez.
Bethany Joy Moyer.
Damian Allen Miller.
Barrett Austin Wingard.
Zane Michael Miller.
Marissa Christina Neuberger.
Margaret Elizabeth McNiff.
Jacob Apachit Nilfi.
Samantha Autumn Diana Myers.
Caitlin Neff Morton.
Caleb Robert Miller.
Kyle Robert Oktavec.
John William Monahan Jr.
Mara Lindsay Novak.
Mary Alyssa McGuinn.
Tyler Edward Newmister.
Alexander James Miller.
Alyssa Hayden Moore.
Elise Marie McCarter.
Dalton James Wise.
Allison Ann Miller.
Andrew Richard Murray.
Brooks A. Morrison.
Kayla Nicole Oberdick.
Eric McNeely Jr.
Shaquille Stallworth.
Shannon Joyce Miller.
Ashley Evelise Reyes.
Emmanuel Elikibo Masengo.
Thank you. Caitlin Margaret Ramsey.
Bryn May McAuliffe.
Tyler Lee Reisinger.
Cody Middle.
Damian J. Reed.
Angela Marie Montoya.
Carrie Ann Elizabeth Reynolds.
Nicholas Lyle Russell.
Elizabeth A. Quickle.
Leah Nicole Ramos.
Benjamin Rawl Jr.
Emma Catherine Stair Piper.
Alexis Victoria Rodolfi.
Tommy Patterson.
Alexa Michelle Pretty.
Brittany Mikkel Lee Pitzer.
Irvin Richardson III.
Kyle Brett Patterson.
Austin Storm Quinones.
Kayla Elizabeth Pillman.
Jennifer Lynn Roberts.
Derek Austin Pfeiffer.
Emily Susan Presley.
Brittany Nicole Poe.
Nathan William Ritz.
Alexander William Patterson.
Jesse Rachel Radowski.
Emily Louise Pettit.
Emilio Luis Pichardo.
David Richard Pelkey.
Ashley Marie Price.
Vasiliki Athanasios Polychronos.
Kyle D. Williams.
Kishan Anil Patel.
Connor Edward Schweinebart.
Jared Thomas Pepper.
Kyle Brandon Simmons.
Ashley Taylor Padone.
Brandon Wayne Spangler.
Zachary Blake Parsley.
Susan Patricia Snow.
Genevieve Catherine Powers.
Lianza Marie Schultz.
Tiffany Panhorst.
Cody Michael Stauffer.
Cameron J. Perry.
Jarrett Edward Skaggs.
Elizabeth Safel.
Carrie Ann Cherie Spar.
Carell Deontra Stanfield. Good enough.
Kalina Shinton Welty.
Elizabeth Gail Sager.
Aaron Joseph Stenklick.
David Gary Rudley.
Christine Mary Spellman.
Benjamin H. Rupert.
Jeremiah A. Simmons.
Abigail L. Rupert.
Alexis Jade Sharp.
Matthew Rosbach.
Trent Daniel Stevens.
Abina Sarfo.
Alexandria Renee Stoffer.
Rachel Ann Rudy.
Clinton McCoy Silver III.
Justin J. Michael Schilling.
Maggie Ann Seitz.
Ryan Logan Rodriguez.
Kyler J. Stifler.
Caitlin Cheyenne Sawmiller.
Hubert D. Shingleton.
Caitlin Renee Rose.
Tia M. Stoffer.
Ryan A. Schrader.
Benjamin Kyle Weaver.
Victoria Josephine Seafelt.
Corinne Marie Viens.
Todd Douglas Y. Jr.
Emily Rose Viens.
Yadaliz Rodriguez Serrano.
Jacob Alexander Ward.
Adam Michael Schick.
April Vang.
Allison Joe Seitz.
Daniel John Webb.
Corey Cottrell Stith Jr.
Rebecca Lee Wagner.
Cassandra N. Young.
Spencer Alexander Wapplinger.
Jacqueline Marie Talbert.
Sally May Trout.
Nolan Ryan Tome.
Sherry Lynn Simi Walsh.
Shannon Rose Swenson.
Jason Jameel Wharton.
Brady Scott Toman.
Lauren May Walters.
Zoe Caitlin Tallman Smith.
Francesco Gaetano Volo.
Ashley Nicole Stiltson.
Michelle E. Timchek.
Eric Donovan Torres.
Thomas Oliver Peter White.
Rachel Marie Taylor.
Alessandro Salvatore Volo.
Eric Joseph Swartz.
Skylar Ashton Walters.
Amy Lynn Stewart.
Laura Margaret Tileston.
Micah Daniel Striebig.
Elliot Austin Wilker.
Ryan Carr Tracy.
Jordan A. Welsh.
Jenna Catherine Toffel.
Katie Amelia Warner.
Mason Ulrich.
Michaela Alexis Zoller.
Sarah E. Stetzer.
Anna M. Washington.
Samuel J. Stillman.
Iyao Zhou.
Amber Nicole Toman.
April N. Zenkovich.
Megan Elizabeth Sterner.
Kayla Nicole Weaver.
Alex J. Van Pelt.
Abigail Irene Wheeler.
Jacob Michael Ward.
Ayana Therese Whedon.
Genesis B. Nunez.
Taylor Morgan Holmes.
Brianne Alyssa Young.
Elizabeth Brianna Whitcomb.
Lauren M. Witzel.
Trevor J. Zero.
Lorraine Krishan Kyra Word.
Catherine Ann Weichert.
Caitlin Angelina Palugi. Serena Grace Womack. Gabrielle Nicole Ziegenfuss. Tara Tess Whitman. Rachel Michelle Zdanowitz. Colleen Michelle Witkowski. Ryan Joseph Zdanowitz. Matthew James Zimardo.
And finally, Andrew Michael Zadoski.
Well, class, we're officially Dallastown graduates now. We no longer go to Dallastown. We went to Dallastown. How crazy is that? That's what's up! Yeah! Now do the tassel.
At this time, you may move your tassel from the right to your left. Ready?
Thank you.